There's four species of humans that have been getting a lot of attention recently, and they are Neanderthals, because after their genome was mapped, it was determined that humans outside of Africa have 1-3% Neanderthal DNA. Another species was Homo floresiensis, which DNA tests determine split with modern humans possibly around 2 million years ago. They were more like Homo habilis than even Homo erectus, and they've updated the time they think they went extinct to around 50,000 years ago or even prior to that. But the thing about Homo floresiensis is they didn't apparently mate with other humans. They were isolated in an island in Indonesia. Another species are the Denisovans, and they still have very little fossil evidence of them, so they don't really know what they look like yet. The fossil evidence for Denisovans is very sparse, but the remains are recent enough that they were able to obtain DNA from the samples, and they've been able to determine that about 3-5% of the DNA of Melanesians and Aboriginal Australians were from Denisovans. So those groups have Denisovan and Neanderthal. The big find recently is Homo naledi. This was from a discovery in a remote cave in South Africa where they found 18 skeletons that were very intact. And scientists were super surprised because the bones had features of humans that were a couple million years old, but the dating on the fossil evidence showed that they were only 200,000 years old. They had the brain the size of a large orange, but they were living only 200,000 years ago, which in anthropological terms is extremely recent, enough so that there were more or less modern humans living alongside them. So the next big thing is to do DNA tests on them, and they believe they're going to be able to extract DNA from the bones. But since this find was so recent, the scientists are speculating, well, who knows, there might be more fossil evidence of Homo naledi that has yet to be uncovered. And they don't know that it went extinct 200,000 years ago or as recently as 10,000 years ago. But once they get that DNA, they'll be able to test it against modern humans and see if anybody in the region has Homo naledi DNA. And there's already a precedent with this sort of thing with the Denisovans and the Neanderthal. And the Homo floresiensis was isolated, so they didn't mix. So maybe Homo naledi might be found in certain percentages in modern humans.